Hey there, everybody, it's me, Cody, on Microsoft, where today I'm excited to be showing you the long-awaited return of true online file integration in Windows. This is OneDrive On Demand. The thing I love most about OneDrive and File Explorer is that it lets me benefit from the conveniences of cloud storage without having to deal with an awful and lethargic web UI. All the files you deal with are literally just in the File Explorer and are exactly the same to use and manage as they always have been for the last two decades. Put a file in the OneDrive folder and it will sync automatically in the background to the cloud. You can now access that file from any device from anywhere. That file will also sync down to any other PC you have logged into that account. Now, your OneDrive folder in the File Explorer looks identical to every other OneDrive folder on every other one of your Windows PCs. If your PC were to explode, no problem. All your files were synced to OneDrive, so after signing into that new PC, all your files will begin trickling back onto that new device. My PC has 1 terabyte of storage on it, so I basically keep all 493 gigabytes of the files that I use in that OneDrive folder, so they're all available in the cloud. This is a problem, though, because my Surface Pro only has 256 gigabytes of internal storage and couldn't possibly sync my whole OneDrive. SkyDrive handled this problem quite well. It just simply didn't download all the files from the cloud onto my Surface Pro. It just showed them. This is exactly how OneDrive On Demand works. Let's take a look. Now, on my Surface Pro, I'm going to drag and drop a document into the OneDrive folder. You'll see that this file will sync and automatically appear on my desktop PC. Opening one of these files would sync it onto your PC to use, and after closing and saving would sync it back up to the cloud onto your other PCs. I have access to all 493 gigabytes of files without them actually being on my device. Of course, if you disconnect from the internet, all these files will become unavailable. The simple solution to that, though, is to just make all the files you want to have available offline. This could be a single document or half of your OneDrive library. It's easy to tell what files are available when, with just 5 little colored icons that tell you the status of that file. A cloud, a spinning arrow, a green check, a solid green check, and a red X. The cloud means that the file is just in the cloud, and not taking up space on your PC. Keep in mind that this file will not be available offline. The spinning arrow means that the file is currently syncing either up to the cloud or down from the cloud. The green check means the file is currently synced onto your PC. The solid green check means that you told your PC to always keep that file downloaded. The red X means there's a conflict, which doesn't happen often, but might if you upload 2 files of the same name from 2 different PCs into the same folder. You can manually change the status of your documents by right-clicking on them. This is very exciting for me because it's really a feature that should never have been removed. I'm looking forward to being able to access all of my OneDrive files without having them all downloaded onto my PC. This feature is currently available for Windows Insiders on the Fast Ring, and will begin rolling out over the next few days. It's a feature that'll have to be enabled by the user once it's received. Anyhow, this has been a quick feature update with me, Cody, on Microsoft. If this video was helpful, make sure to subscribe and check out onmicrosoft.com for more info. Thank you. Goodbye.